Good morning. It's Vegan Girl 29 here, and I usually try to stay on very positive life lessons, but I think it's time for me to give a lesson to you younger ladies. See, when I was growing up, I didn't have the rights that you have today. I had very limited options, but you know what? I took every single opportunity to better myself because I knew one day I would have little girls. At least I hoped I'd have little girls because I wanted their life a lot better than mine. Now, a lot of you may not know this, but I was raised up totally different than most American women were. I was raised up very restricted. And when I say restricted, I mean restricted. You did as you were told and nothing more. Women were devalued. I'm the first woman in my family not to be married at the age of 14 years old. I was the first woman in my family to have a high school education. Not because I was allowed it, because I got it after I got to the age where I could go back to school. I wanted the education. I wanted a better life than what was offered living in the lifestyle I was in, that I was brought up in. It was very prejudiced. It was very violent. Men were gods. You did what they said, period. You didn't argue or you got knocked down. Hi, Candy. That's my puppies. We weren't called, pardon my language, we weren't called bitches. We weren't called whores. We weren't spoken to that way. But we were verbally abused, physically abused. It wasn't that uncommon for a woman to be spanked by her husband. Women of the day don't understand that that is gone by the wayside. Thank God. I told my husband before I married him, if you ever lay your hands on me, I'll kill you dead. And I meant it. No matter how much you love somebody, there's still limits. And I put the limits out there. I told him before even I said I do, and I took my vows very seriously. And I didn't say to honor and obey. I said to honor and cherish. See, the obey was a lot of what the women before me had to do. And some in my generation chose to do it because that's what they were brought up and they didn't have the fight in them. Well, I had fight in me. And that fight made it better for each and every one of you women there now. Because if I would have bowed down and said, I do, I obey, it wouldn't change your lives. There was a lot of things that we did, but we never once went out with pussy hats on our heads. Vaginas out. Vulgar language being spread because you know what? We are raising up our daughters. We want them to be the kind of women that we admire, that other people admire. Ashley Judd is not admired. Madonna is not admired. Sorry. Hillary Clinton is not admired. She's not. Yes, Trump said some things 12 years ago, but let's see, Madonna spent her whole career being vulgar. Ashley Judd, vulgar. And countless others. Now, it is hard enough being a woman. Compile the fact that you have other women disenfranchising you because you have a little bit of a different belief system than them. Uncalled for. I'm still a woman. There's many women like me. And our voices weren't heard. They weren't allowed to be heard because you liberal lefties, and I'm going to call you out, decided that it was better to disenfranchise us than to actually acknowledge our freedom, our freedoms. There was women there that were forced to leave, their hair set afire because they chose to go, but they were attacked. And don't say they weren't, because they have video evidence of them being attacked. What are you afraid of? Are you going to be afraid? Y'all say, my body, my choice. Wrong. Wrong, 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 wrong. And I'm going to tell you why you're wrong. It might be your body and it might be your choice before you get pregnant, when you have every opportunity to keep yourself from getting pregnant. That's when you have the choice. After you get pregnant, that's not a choice. You're taking that choice away from another human being. I'm a vegan. I don't kill animals. I don't eat animals. And I sure enough don't agree with women killing their own babies. Sorry, I don't. I think it's pathetic. There are free clinics all over our nation. You can get condoms. You can get free birth control. You can get birth control that can last up to 3 to 5 years where you don't even have to remember to take a pill. There's absolutely no reason for any woman to have to choose an abortion. Now, before you start criticizing what I'm saying, I understand that there are incest. I understand there's rapes. I understand that there's other things and other medical issues that happen. But that's none of your damn concern. That's that person's concern. It's the law's concern. It's our legal system's concern. You're saying, well, that's going to take the right away from them. Well, the thing is there's different circumstances in which the law allows things to happen. If a father impregnates a daughter, the likelihood of that baby being okay is minuscule. We know this. Even if they come out with 10 fingers, 10 toes, the problems that they could have and everything else, it's great. But still, we leave it up to the professionals. It's not your choice. It isn't your choice. It isn't your right to choose for anybody else. Now, if you tried to prevent pregnancy and you got pregnant and you decide you want an abortion, okay. All the power to the world to you, even though I don't agree with it. But my tax dollars don't have to pay for it. If you could not keep yourself from getting pregnant, you need to deal with it. Sorry. You do. Men, Y'all need to step up and start taking responsibility by who you lay down with. If you don't want a baby, cover it up. There are men precautions to keep you from getting pregnant. It's your fault too. If you insist on your woman or the person you slept with to get an abortion because you're not ready to have a baby, then you weren't ready to have sex. Same for you women. If you are not ready to have a child, you're not ready to have sex. Period. See, I taught my daughters. I did. I taught my son too. My eldest child, she's married and has children. My second oldest child's married and has a child. My third daughter, she's getting married. My son, he's still living the single life and has no interest in dating right now. So, what I tell them? Sex complicates things. You don't really get to know a person when you're laying in the bed with them. You don't. See, you lose all interest after that, and there's nothing more for you to explore. When you take the time to explore the person from here and here before anything else, you have a better chance. This free love that's going around is free STDs. And you don't realize how many people sleep around. So you don't know how many people that one's been with, or the other, or them and everything else. And you don't know what diseases they have. You might get something that Ajax can't cleanse and penicillin can't kill. Be smart. And you women, you liberal women, okay, show your freaking vaginas. But the fact of the matter is what you're doing is disgracing yourselves, because I'm going to tell you what, my daughters ain't going to do it. I don't care how old they are. They're not going to do it. Modesty. Now, there's a lot of things this... I'm going to tell you what I am. And a lot of people are like, what the heck did she just say? I am a Masonic Jewish vegan. That means I live by the word of Jesus Christ and his teachings. By the principles of the Jewish faith. Okay? That's what that means. And veganism means I'm not going to eat anything that comes from an animal or use it on my hair, my face, anything. Because I believe that all life is sacred. Even that unborn child that y'all so desperately want the right to kill. See, y'all don't understand where Planned Parenthood came from. Maybe it's time for you to get a history lesson. See, there was this woman that thought that blacks and Jewish people and Indians and the undesirable sex, and most of them were African Americans, were unsavory, that they shouldn't breed, that they needed to be sterilized. So she started Planned Parenthood. And they offered free abortions, but when they did the abortions, they made it where women could not get pregnant. Because they were wanting to eradicate the races. She wanted a superhuman race. So could you imagine, you women of the world, if you were selected to be sterilized? Against your will, because the man that you laid down with and he said he loved you wasn't ready to have a child and he put you in an unsavory position. So you either went to a butcher or Planned Parenthood, which, okay, you went to Planned Parenthood, the baby was taken care of, so to say, but now you couldn't have any more children beyond your own self. No life beyond your own. Now, how radical is that? Now, let's come to present day Planned Parenthood. They were selling babies' parts. Now, when my son Michael died, and I have a lot of respect for women that miscarry. I lost 3 children to miscarriage. And I was very far along on 2 of them. And to see a baby that little tears you up. Now, I donated Michael's body. I donated it. Because there was other little children, other little babies that could benefit and needed what he had. And it makes me so upset, but I donated his precious body for humanity. And it was one of the hardest things I had to do. But to see a woman do this purposely? To kill a child purposely? It's unfathomable. And for them just to dissect that infant and do god-awful things for stem cells and other things, it's appalling. Simply appalling. And yes, I said I had 3. But Matthew Mark wasn't viable enough to have his organs or his heart, you know, those things done, or his eyes to benefit. But I still donated his body because I wanted people to learn. I wanted our future doctors to learn. I thought it very important that education be there. And the only way that they could have it is if they had cadavers, be it infant or not. But he wasn't aborted. He was loved very much. Now, my 3rd was early on. I was pregnant with triplets and I lost one. And I'm very fortunate to have my 2 youngest children living today, you know, and this was over 20 years ago. It still hurts. So if you think about ever having an abortion, you need to see what it actually entails. And listen to women that have gone through miscarriages and have had prior abortion. Most of them, 99% of them, regret the decision that they ever made. There are women that were forced to have abortions that didn't want to have an abortion, and it plagues their lives daily. It never goes away. And you women that do had the march, stop disenfranchising women like me. Because without women like me, you don't have a place. You need to start taking care of our homeless women. Do you know that our homeless women don't have the base? You're saying, oh, well, men can get Rogaine and Viagra and things like that, but women have to pay a tax on tampons and pads. Well, why don't you think about this, you white and black and Hispanic and Indian and all you privileged American women out there on the left. If you cared so much about your fellow woman, you would care to know that most of the women that are homeless don't have sanitary napkins. They don't have tampons. They don't have the luxuries that you complain about having to pay a few cents tax on. So why don't you go and buy a freaking case of pads and donate it to a woman's shelter, a homeless shelter? You know, get off your moral high horse and do something instead of trying to march around like feminists. The only thing feminist about that march was the name. I didn't see nothing feminine about it. You know, y'all want to be equal to men? Here we go. You want to be equal to a man? You want the same rights and privileges as a man? Okay. You fix your own pipes. You do everything a man does. You need to be signing up for the draft. Don't think it's only for a man. If you want the same rights as a man, then you need to do everything a man does. Well, I'm a woman. I have this and this and this responsibility. You know what? God made us separate but equal. We are not supposed to be doing what men do. Their bodies were made different than yours and mine. Our hands are smaller. Our feet are smaller. We're frailer than a man. We were built differently. It's not that we're less than a man. It's just we're different. So, well, if we're doing the same job, well, you know what? If you're doing the same job, hoorah to you, and you deserve every bit of the pay that the man gets. Equality means equality if you're doing the same job. But if you're not, shut up. Shut up. There ain't nothing wrong with being a housewife, and don't disenfranchise them because that's one of the hardest jobs in the world. I did it for daggum 24 years. I raised 12 kids up out of here. You think that was easy? You get up at 5:30 in the morning, start cooking breakfast, and get the kids off to school, and then you do all your household chores, running around, bill paying, and then you have to go to school because your child did this, or they forgot that, and you have this meeting here, and you have to have a doctor's appointment there, and then you have to rush back home for the rest of them to get off the bus for you to start homework, and then you have to get dinner, and then you have to get them baths, and then you have to get story time and individual time with each and every one of them, and then you have to get them in the bed and everything else, and you have to fight with them getting them in the bed. It sometimes takes 2 and 3 hours to get them to sleep. And then you're still up 2-3 hours after you put the kids to sleep, cleaning up after dinner. Not getting into bed till 11, 12 o'clock, just to get up 5.5 hours later to start it all over again. Don't tell me that their job, our jobs, are not as important as yours because we are raising the kids up. That's what y'all need to be thinking about. When y'all were marching the other day, you didn't think about women like me. You didn't think about other women. You didn't think about women like my daughter Rachel that has 3 kids. She has to get up in the daggum morning, cook breakfast for, walk to the daggum school bus to make sure they're safe. You're not even considering women like her. And it sickens me because my daughters are phenomenal. They're phenomenal women. And it's because how I raised them. I raised them to be polite, not to be going out and talking like y'all. That trash talking mouths y'all got. I am so disrespectful. That's disrespectful, women. Come on. And then y'all put down President Trump like he did something to you. What did he do? Specifically to you, what did he do? Okay? I know what Hillary did, personally. I know what her husband did, personally. But what did Trump do to you, personally? Nothing. But see, you want to overlook the obvious because you don't want to face the fact and face the truth. See, the thing is y'all believe y'all won the election and it was robbed from you. Well, the fact of the matter is it wasn't robbed from you. You never had it. And until you understand that, you're not going to have a very happy and productive life. Stop disenfranchising people. Stop being rude and disrespectful to people. Just like that woman on the airplane. Guy comes on board the airplane, he gets in a seat. He was wearing a t-shirt that had Trump on it. He didn't say nothing to nobody, but then he was attacked because of their shirt. You know, saying, you believe in gravity? Gravity's just a theory. Do you believe in climate control? Come on, ladies. How are we supposed to be taken seriously if you keep doing this? If you attack, this exactly what you're going to get back. And it's not pretty. It's just not. I taught my daughters by telling them my story and telling them what I did not want for their story. See, my grandmother married my grandfather on my father's side. 13 years old. Arranged marriage. Had 9 children. At 40 years old, she came up missing. The relationship was very volatile. He was very abusive. And he said that he explained to the kids that she ran off with another a married man. Well, come to find out years later, he shot her in the head, cut her up, put her parts in a crab traps, threw in the ocean, and left her. After a certain amount of time, went back and got the crab traps, and disposed of the bones without it being discovered. How I know this is my father was involved. He took me to the bridge where he said that his father shot her. Over jealousy. My mother. Never met her. I was told that I was a throwaway baby found in garbage. Truth of the matter is I believe my father killed her. I think he did exactly what he was taught to do, generation after generation after generation. My sister. 9 years old, murdered by my father, witnessed by my brother, because she was different. Of course, you know, family members, oh, it's an accident. Nah, that's not what happened. 3 generations of women murdered, and not one time did any law enforcement or anyone step in. Disenfranchise women like me, because I taught my daughters, if you are uncomfortable, you say no. You have a voice. Choose how you use it. I want you strong. I want you educated. I want you capable of taking care of yourself. I want you to be able to depend on you, no one else but you, for all your needs. I didn't want them victims. See, I was a victim. To a certain point, I was a victim. To the point that I left, and I never looked back. My brother died in prison not even 2.5 years ago. He beat women his whole entire life. He has a son. I saw him once when he was a baby. Talked to him twice on the phone. What am I supposed to say about his dad? Nothing I can say to him is anything good about what his father ever did. The only good thing he ever did was have him. That was it. He raped my daughter. Four generations of women affected. You know how that plays on a woman? It's the hardest thing you could ever imagine. But you know what? There's no support system for that. Why aren't you fighting for it? Yeah, they're marching for women's rights, but those things were never mentioned. None of it. And there's worse stories than mine. There are. I know a woman down the street that was beaten so daggum bad, she had so many strokes, she doesn't even sound intelligent, even though she's very intelligent. People treat her like she's a retarded person because the man she chose to marry and loved so much beat her to death. They brought her back to death and only spent 1 year in jail. But you don't hear about her rights. Are you marching for her? How about the 13-year-old girl that was kidnapped and brought over the Mexican-American border to be sold as a sex slave in the United States and was left at an ER in an undisclosed location and almost died and spent 6 months recuperating in the hospital. What about her rights? What about all the children that are being trafficked across the borders? 90% of them are little girls. What about their rights? So don't stand on your high pedestals telling me what you're fighting for when all I hear is a bunch of crap coming out your mouths and no change for the people that are really suffering is coming down. And you ridicule a man that says, you know what? I'm tired of these criminals coming into our country and doing this. Do you honestly think he was talking about the immigrants that come and work in our fields or whatever else job? No, he was talking about the violent ones that rape our women and our children, the ones that take them from country to country, selling their bodies until they're all used up. What about them? Why can't you just let him build the wall without your snide remarks and everything else and think of the good it can could come out of it? No more drugs coming across our borders. Disease. That's what it is. The drugs are diseases that our people are catching. But you don't see it. You don't want to see it. When there's drugs, there's prostitution. When there's prostitution, there are women. And when there's women, there are little girls. And when there's little girls, there's pervert men. And the bottom dollar is what they're after. They don't care for their rights. They don't care for our rights. All they see is a profit, what we can make them. And don't tell me that ain't something to be concerned about. Don't tell me that ain't human rights. Don't tell me that ain't a woman's right. I want our women and our girls to have the right to walk down the street regardless of what they choose to wear without getting hit on or spat on or anything vulgar happening to them because a man decides that they're sex and sex object. And I also want our women to be held accountable by what they're putting out for our little girls. If you're out there, Miley Cyrus, what kind of example are you setting for our little children, our little girls? You want your daughter doing what you're doing? You think it's okay? It's not. You say it's for adults, but it's really not. Your music does not target adult ears. Your music targets teens, teen girls. They look up to you, and what do they see? Not anything moral. And then you say, oh, I'm offended. Madonna, same with you. What story, other than showing your crotch, being sex, using your body to sell sex, to make your fortune, what part of that benefits the American woman? How does that empower our girls? To be known of, to only be known as sex objects? Offering blowjobs to anyone that voted for Hillary. How does that teach our girls about morals, self-respect? It doesn't. So all you people out there, all you women of the left that think that you have it all figured out, y'all have nothing figured out. You have no monopoly on suffering. You have no monopoly on understanding, and you sure enough don't have the monopoly on talking women's rights without including all women. Because you sure enough didn't include anyone of the conservative movement. You did not even have one there without having issues. You said, no, we don't want you here. We don't want you. We don't want your kind. What? I'm a woman. I have breasts and I have a vagina. What are the other requirements? Tell me. Isn't that what you're fighting for? Our rights as women? Well, if you're fighting for my rights, you didn't speak for me. Be kind to one another. Love one another. Embrace the differences of one another. See, I can disagree with you without hating you. I can disagree with you without calling you, excuse me, names. I can disagree with you without being a racist or homophobe or transphobe or whatever other label you want to label me. Because I'm going to let you know right now, I was the first one to say, in my generation, if I marry you and one of our children just comes to us and say that they are gay, how would you deal with it? If my husband would have said that that's a deal breaker, that he would kick him out, that was a deal breaker. Because unconditional love means unconditional love. Do I agree with same sex? No, but it's not my life. See, that's the thing. Y'all are trying to put y'all's way on everybody and it doesn't work. And y'all are saying, well, the conservatives are. Well, you know what? The conservatives didn't say that you can't go and have an abortion. All they're saying is we don't want to pay for it. It's not birth control. That's it. Where'd that come into? They're anti-abortion. They don't care about your rights as women. No, absolutely not. I believe that abortion is not a form of birth control. Period. But the thing is, this is not my body, but it ain't gonna use my money. I don't think Planned Parenthood should be funded by the government. I don't. If you're impoverished, where you cannot afford an abortion, I'm sorry. You still have the opportunity to get the free birth control that is offered at any health department across the nation. And you can utilize every single method that is available to you. This goes for women and men alike. So please, this isn't about an abortion issue or a Trump issue or a conservative issue or a leftist issue. Is about a human issue, and we need to start treating each other like human beings. Stop the violence. Stop the rhetoric. Stop the lies. Just stop. And if anybody on that is a Trump supporter that's watching this and everything else, if you see a fellow Trump supporter going and doing something that is not cool and is hateful, call them out. And you lefties, if you see one of y'all going out acting a fool and doing something that you know is not right, you need to call them out and have it stopped. This ain't the world of eye for an eye. You always say love trumps hate, but the fact of the matter is I don't see very much love. Love equals love. That's the new slogan. Love equals love. Some will say it again. Love equals love. Vegan Girl 29, I love all of you. And I will get into more of my story in a later vlog. Bye.